Really, the thing that Eric mentioned is so important, that you all as local trainers are the local examples that you present. Because, you know, St. Cloud, Minneapolis, St. Paul, so many variations on the regions in the state. The more examples you can generate and put into your kind of toolkit, the better your ability to train, I think. But the core features have to be there. I mean, yeah, those are the things that are always going to be the same. And I say that on purpose because if you were to go to Taiwan, if you went to New Zealand, if you go to Sweden, you'll see the same core features. The tiered logic, the notion about outcomes and practice and systems, the use of data decision making, teaching social skills directly, those are all going to be the same core features. What's different, though, is the language you're going to use, the examples you're going to generate, how you're going to, you know, Minnesota accent or whatever. You know, you're going to have variations that are going to make it real locally. Stay really kind of close to those core features because that's what will ground you. But you really got to build that set of examples because that's what gets people hooked up to what you're doing. Eric's right. I can come in and drop in and give ideas, but really what happens is that transfer to the local that matters. So kind of keep that in mind as you go through it. I mean, I'm really lucky. I get to go to all these countries. It's fascinating to see how the same core features are there. What varies is how they sound and look and the examples in general. There's a little bit of difference sometimes when certain cultures kind of live corporal punishment and whatever, but you know, caning and all that kind of thing in Taiwan is still there, so you're going to have to compete against some of that stuff as well, but it's pretty important for you.